Friends, in this session we will learn about the part 3 of the basics of consumption based planning, which is on material master records. So here we will create material master records and explain the MRP data. We'll describe the functions of the MRP profile and create one MRP profile. How to create one MRP profile and what are the standard MRP profiles available. So if you want, we can create our own profile by copying from any standard MRP profile and changing the fields as per our business requirement. And also here we will explain the meaning of the material status. Coming to the MRP data in the material master record, which is the MRP data in the material master record? The MRP data in the material master record is MRP type, plant delivery time, in-house production time, lot size indicator, MRP controller and scheduling margin key. We already know about the general data, which is about the material description, unit of measure. Procurement data also we know. Accounting data that is for the accounting purpose. So it has the valuation clause and valuation procedure and valuation price. Then storage location data, that is the data stored at the storage location level. And the forecast data. So here in the forecast data, we will input the consumption values of the material in the past, maybe for the past 1 year, monthly consumption. Okay. The MRP relevant data is stored at plant level in the material master record in MRP 1, 2, 3 and 4 views. Normally, that is we will be storing in MRP 1 and 2 views. MRP data in the material master record can be subdivided into the following categories. General data that we must or can always define for a material, for a planning material. Data dependent on MRP procedure. Then data required for scheduling. Data required for lot size calculation. Of course, to create a material master record and with the MRP views, we can use the transaction code MM01. Now, what is MRP profile? So, we can maintain MRP parameters with MRP profiles. A MRP profile is a key under which we can define MRP parameters independent of the material master record. The information set in the MRP profile is standard information that is needed again and again for maintaining MRP data in different materials. A profile simplifies maintenance and administration of MRP data. We can specify the following in MRP profile. Which fields have to be entered when entering MRP data in the material master record? Which of these values in the material master record can be overwritten? That is for the default values or the default fields. And which cannot be overwritten, that is which are the for the fixed values or fixed fields. So here in this diagram I have shown, that is one MRP profile, standard MRP profile 0001 is shown. So for this profile, the standard values are MRP type is BB, which is manual reorder point planning, MRP controller is 001, scheduling margin key is 001, and the default values are reorder point 500 and safety stock 50. Okay, default value means, that is, we can change them in the material master record after copying all this from the MRP profile. So, for example, let us say I have a material 1, okay, for the plant 1000 and MRP profile 0001. So, when creating the material master record, that is when I am creating MRP 1 and 2 views of the material master record. Instead of manually putting all these values like MRP type, MRP controller, scheduling margin key, reorder point, safety stock, if I just input the MRP profile 0001, then system will copy all these values into the material master record. And no need of inputting all of these fields manually. Okay, that is the advantage of MRP profile, and it also saves our valuable time. Okay. That is, by automatically It is extracting all the values of these fields from the MRP profile instead of manually inputting all these values one by one. Okay. To create a MRP profile, we can follow the path in the SAP EasyAccess screen, logistics, material management, material master, profile, MRP profile, create. Okay, here this is the one. MMD1 is the transaction code to create, MMD2 to change, MMD3 to display, and MMD7 to usage. That is, we can find how many materials are having that MRP profile for a particular plant in MMD7. So, when creating material master records, we need to enter a MRP profile. Okay, fixed values copied from the MRP profile cannot be changed in the material master records, but default values copied from the MRP profile can be overwritten and changed as per our requirement. Finally, the material master record is saved. If the business requirement is to change a profile itself, okay, not the default values in the material master record, I mean to change the certain values in the profile itself, then we can update all the material master records having the profile with the changes in the fields in the material master records as per the changes in the profile by running a background job using program RMM0001. For all materials with changes, a change document is automatically created. The time at which the batch job is started is defined in the system administration in customizing for logistics general material master tools define start time of background jobs. Okay, we can set the background job to start at any particular time as per our convenience. Okay, so that is once we run this background job, then what the system will do? The system will update all the material master records using that particular profile with the new values from the profile into the fields in the material master records. If the background job terminates for any reason, we must manually update the material master records by creating a background job for program RMM0001. Okay, we can list the material master records that use the same MRP profile by choosing from logistics, material management, material master, profile, MRP profile, usage. The transaction code is MMD7. We can limit the selection according to plant and MRP controller as well as using MRP profiles. We can also use forecast profiles to manage forecast data. The processing of forecast profiles follows the same principle as the one for MRP profiles. Okay, to similar to the MRP profile, we can also create forecast profiles and that is maintain the the consumption values of the material and use the same forecast profile for the material master record to maintain the forecast values instead of manually inputting the forecast values. Okay. Now, let me go to this. I will show you one MRP. Let us go to MRP profile. Logistics, material management, material master, profile, MRP profile, for example here, display, let us display. So ZVB1 is one MRP profile available in standard SAP. So here we can see which are the fixed values and which are the default values. So for this MRP profile ZVB1, we can see that only the lot size material planning is fixed value. And all the other values, all the other fields are default values. That means we can change them in the material master record, like MRP type, MRP controller, plant delivery time, index, scheduling margin key, safety stock, reorder point, and fixed losses. All these are default values. Okay. And what are these values? We can see the actual values in data screen. Click data screen one. The MRP type is VB. MRP controller 101, plant delivery time 3 days, safety stock is 20 pieces, reorder point is 100, scheduling margin key is 001, and lot size is FX. This is the fixed value. Okay, we cannot change it in the metal master record, the lot size. It is in blue color here. Fixed lot size is 500. Okay, we can also see any other MRP profile. Let us say ZVB2 here. Here in the MRP profile ZBB2, the fixed values are MRP controller, then plant delivery time in days. These two are fixed. And all the other are default values. That means all the other default values we can change in the Metal Master record. Okay. Apart from that one, we also have other MRP profile, VM01. So here there is nothing fixed. All are default values. Automatic reorder plant planning. Then VV01, let us say. This is manual reorder point planning. So here also there is nothing fixed. So all are default values. Okay, like this, you know, these are the standard actually. These are the standard settings in the SAP. So we can use all the profiles, okay, which are available. Let me go to FR, I will show you the list of profiles which are available in the standard SAP system. We can go to any of these and see what are the standard settings available. And also, if we want to create our own profile with our own fixed fields and default fields, then we can copy from any of these profiles and give a some name to our own name to our profile and description and use it for our business process. Okay, that is about the MRP profiles. Okay, so and also now by using the transaction code MMD7, we can see how many materials, okay, are having this particular profile in a particular plant. For example, I will go to SAP screen. Okay, I will go to MMD7 MRP usage. For example, here MRP profile, for example, here ZVB1 in plant 1111. How many materials are having this MRP profile? Just put the MRP profile and plant and click execute. You can select the selection of plant data and MRP area data. This button, radio button, execute. So we can see three materials, M4001, 4002 and 4003 are assigned with MRP profile ZVB1 in plant 1111. Okay. So now we have seen how to use the usage of the MRP profile. Then material status. What is the material status? The material status restricts the usability of a material and determines which functions in material management or production planning and control result in a warning or an error message. In other words, with the assignment of a material status to a material, we determine for which business usages the material is indented. Okay, so we can determine the material status and its controlling characteristics in customizing for logistics general, material master, settings for key fields, define material statuses. We can assign a material status to a material in the Metal Master record either at the plant level, I mean at the MRP one view, or cross plant level, which is in the basic data one view. So let us go to customizing and see that is what are the material status available and it is what are the settings available for the standard material statuses. Let me go to SAP now. Okay, so the path is here. Logistics General, Material Master, Settings for Key Fields, Define Material Statuses. Okay, execute this one. So, one standard material status is 01, blocked for procurement and warehouse. And we have one block for purchasing, which is BP, okay, like this. So, and all these are standard material statuses available in the SAP system. So, let us see what is this material status 01, which is blocked for procurement and warehouse. So, I will select this 01 and click details. So here the purchasing message is B, means error. So let me go to that B, F4, and see it is the error message. That means if a material is having the material status BP, then if somebody tries to create a purchase order or purchase requisition or contract anything, system will give you an error message. And also, if we try to plan the material and execute the planning run for that particular material, that then also that is we will get an error message. That means the system will not allow us to do the planning run for the material or create any purchasing document manually for that material with the status BP, blood for purchasing. Okay. Another one, let me see. I have here blood for purchasing. Yeah, BP. Let me just see this one. Blood for procurement warehouse. What is this one? I have seen this one. So here, blood for procurement warehouse. So here, purchasing also. That is, we cannot procure the material. If we try to do the planning run for the material, or try to create a purchase acquisition or purchase order or any other purchasing document, then also we will get the error message. Okay. And here, the forecasting also, we will get error message. MRP also, we cannot do the planning run also for this material. Okay. So we will get the error message, MRP message. So this is blocked for procurement and warehouse. Okay. In the previous one, that is, it is blocked for purchasing. So this is blocked for purchasing. So here it is only blocked for purchasing, but that is MRP we can do, MRP run we can do, and forecasting also we can do here. That is, we will not get any message. Only if you are trying to create a purchase order or any purchasing document, we will get the error message for the material status BP. Okay. It is about the material status. Okay. Now, this is the material status here. So I have shown you that one. Okay. Then material master record maintenance. Okay. Now we will do a small exercise and maintain a material master record. So before that one, we will display one. So I think we have already seen this one. MRP profile ZBB one. We know that the lot size field is fixed here, and all the other are default values, default fields, and these are the values here in the MRP profile. MRP type VB, MRP controller 101, scheduling margin key 001, and all these things. Now we are I have a problem here. We are going to use a new raw material in plant 1111. When creating the material master record, use existing MRP profile ZBB1. Create a new material master record with the following data. So we will use the material internal number M-4004, mechanical engineering raw material, material type. We will create the basic data 1-2, purchasing MRP 1-2, and accounting 1 views. Okay, we will put all these values and create the material master record. And also, that is, the management also wants to maintain, that is, some consumption values for this material. Okay. Okay, that is because they feel that the planning department has informed that this material is to be used in our manufacturing plant, and its consumption will be as per below table. In order to use the forecast at a later time, we need to store the consumption values of this material in the material master record. Then we can branch to the additional data of the material master record, and in the consumption tab, we can input all these, that is, the values in the for the monthly, that is the monthly usage. Okay, so now let us create this material and also add the consumption values as per here. So let me go to SAP. So he has given the MRP profile ZBB1. Okay, I will go to SAP. The transaction code to create a material is MM01. Okay, we give the material number M40004. Industry is mechanical engineering. Material type is raw material. Enter. We want to create basic data 1-2, purchasing, MRP 1-2, and accounting 1 view. Enter. So plant is 1111. Storage location 1111. MRP profile we have to use as ZBB1. Okay, as given here. Okay, ZBB1. Okay, continue. And what is the description here given as? Just copy this one. Rod, stainless steel, 22 mm, 125 mm. Okay. Then base unit of measure is piece. Material group 001. Enter. It will go to the purchasing view. Basic data 2, nothing. In the purchasing view, what is the purchasing group? Purchasing group. Okay, 001. You will put simple 001. Then enter. It will, now it has gone to MRP 1, 2, views. In the we can see that in the MRP one view, it is the MRP type, reorder point, MRP controller, then lot size and fixed lot size. Everything is copied from the MRP profile ZVB1. Okay, because we have seen that in the MRP profile ZVB1 here in display ZVB1 here, it is only the lot size is a fixed value. We go to data screen 1. So MRP type is VB, MRP controller 101, MRP type is VB, MRP controller 101. Then plant delivery time 3 days, safety stock 20. Okay, safety stock. Okay, safety stock is the next page. We will see that one. Then that is in the MRP 2 view, safety stock. Reorder point is 100, scheduling margin key is 001, fixed lot size is 500. Okay, fixed lot size is 500 and lot size is FX. The lot size is, this is a fixed field, we cannot change here. That is why it is grayed here in the metal master guide. FX we cannot change because this is fixed value. Okay, now in the MRP 2 view, the other values will be there. I will go to MRP 2 view. Yeah. Scheduling margin key 001, plant delivery time is 3 days and safety stock is 20. So these three fields are in the, these three fields are available in MRP 2 view. Okay, so plant delivery time, safety stock and scheduling margin key, they are in the MRP 2 view. Okay, now enter. In the accounting one view, what are the values we need to input? Valuation class 3000, moving average price is 100 rupees. Okay, valuation class 3000, moving average price is 100 rupees. Okay, enter. Once we maintain the material, we will get the message material so and so created. Okay, material M4004 is created. Okay, so we have created the material by copying the values from the MRP profile ZBB1, and also we need to maintain the consumption values. I think we forgot actually. We can just go to the change mode and do the same here. Here, material change immediately. Okay, enter. We can go to any of the either purchasing or anyone, MRP1, any of this one, and just enter. So here go to additional data. So here we need to go to the consumption tab page. In the consumption tab, so we will maintain the usage of the material. Previous month 450, previous month 1 430, like that. Previous month 450, previous to previous 430, then that is the previous month is, that is December, this is January 2020, previous month is we will start from December, November, October, September, like that. Okay, then previous to that month 360. Okay, then we have 350, 340. 340, then 360, 370. 360, you scroll down and 370. So these are, that is from the previous month to previous month 10. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So 11 months we have maintained the values. Here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Okay. So the consumption values also we have maintained. Okay. Now we can just save this material. Okay. Material is changed. That is done. Okay. So we have created the material as per the MRP profile ZVV1 and also the consumption values. Okay. As per the requirement by the planning department. Next, we can check the usage of the MRP profile ZVV1 in plant. How many materials are assigned? Okay. Now, let us go to MMT7 and see the latest status of the number of materials having this MRP profile ZVV1 in plant 1111. I will go to MMT7, double click ZVV1 plant 1111. Execute. Okay, we can see 4 materials are assigned to the MRP profile ZVB1 in plant 1111. So the latest material, that is the which we have created just now with MRP profile ZVB1, that is M-4004, is also updated in the list actually. So this is about the material master record in consumption based planning. Okay, so in my next video, that is we will know about the reorder point planning in the basics of consumption based planning. Okay, thank you for watching my video. Please give me your valuable likes, comments, and also please subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon so that you will get notification of my upcoming videos on several scenarios in SAP MM. Thank you for watching again.